lot of bond ETFs are now throwing off yields of 1 to 2% range. I don't know if we can put this up, but here's some yields of some big ETFs that are out there. The big one, AGG, the aggregate bond, 1.2%. The LQD, investment grade corporates, only throwing off about 2%. The munis are throwing off 2%. High yield, about 6%. So I guess the question is, what do you do about all of this? And Christian, I'm going to turn to you. You've got your Amplify High Income ETF, YYY, which I find very interesting. It tracks an index of U.S.-listed closed-end funds. Now, this has a much higher yield, but it's a slightly different product because you're dealing with closed-end funds. Very briefly, could you tell us what's in this and why you think this is an alternative for people looking for yield?
Sure. So closed-end funds are, you know, kind of the lesser-known type of fund in the U.S. There's mutual funds, there's exchange-traded funds, and there's closed-end funds. Closed-end funds actually started, though, before all three of those categories. The odd thing about closed-end funds is that they often trade below their net asset value, meaning you can buy them at a discount to what the actual securities are valued. So YYY tracks an index of discounted closed-end funds. These closed-end funds are stock and bond closed-end funds managed by some of the biggest names in the industry, BlackRock, Legg Mason, and Nuveen, and they're all designed to produce high current income. So YYY's index seeks to own 30 that have a kind of the highest blend of discount to NAV as well as distribution rate. So currently, YYY owns 30 closed-end funds that trade at a 13% discount to NAV, and what that does is produce high current income. The current SEC yield on YYY is 8.85%. You know, how can we do that? Essentially, we're buying a dollar's worth of assets for 87 cents. That's that closed-end fund discount that we're taking advantage of, and then those funds themselves are all income-oriented. So this is a more volatile income investment from an NAV standpoint. The trade-off is you should get quite a bit more high current income over time. So this, we think, is an alternative to some of the traditional bond ETFs. It's an ETF of closed-end funds trading at a discount. I think it's fairly unique and potentially, you know, if you're thinking about an income investment, it's probably one side of an income barbell. Okay. You may have more low volatility, conservative income investments on one side. On the other side, a higher yielding, more volatile side of the barbell, which YYY would fit in.
Okay, John, this sounds like a great deal. 9%, who doesn't want 9% yield versus 5 or 6% for a high yield fund? But then again, you're in closed end funds. Is there something we need to be mindful of here, John?
Yes, I think you need to be mindful that the discount to net asset value may never close. There's no guarantee that these things will reach their net asset value. They are expensive. And I think that investors should really look at total return as opposed to just pure yield. So going back to what I mentioned before about IPOs, if you're going to take on the risk of owning a financial asset, you should be compensated for taking that risk, right? Same thing like, you know, in life, right? If you're going to start a business, you should be compensated for starting a business. And I just don't think that happens with closed-end funds. I see a volatility, a standard deviation of about 17%, which is the same standard deviation as the S&P 500 ETF. And then if we talk about the total return over the last 3 years, you know, the S&P 500, you know, has produced a total return of 50%, you know, whereas YYY has a total return of about 2%. I think there's other ways to generate yield if people are just going to be purely focused on yield and they've got, you know, if they're running a pension fund and trying to match, you know, liabilities and assets. But, you know, LQD, I think, is attractive from a yield perspective. I think PFF is attractive from a yield perspective. Even HYD, the high yield muni ETF, I think is pretty attractive. All those have much lower standard deviations, higher total returns. So on a yield per unit risk basis, I think that, you know, you're better off in those areas compared to closed-end funds. You know, I think the key is just to be mindful that these things may never reach net their net asset value.
Okay. Again, all sorts of alternatives out there. This is a question, probably one of the top three questions. What do we do? How can I get better yield? So I thought we'd bring up some alternative investments.